To set up a match type, you create data sources, create transaction types, and then create match processes. In this video, we cover creating data sources. I'll start by creating a new match type for matching accounts receivable invoices to accounts payable invoices for intercompany transactions. I'll assign a unique ID, a name, and a description. Match types have a status of pending or approved. Set the status to pending when you want to edit the match type configuration. You cannot load data or perform matching for reconciliations whose match type status is pending. You must save the match type before you can create data sources. You use the Data Source tab to define the data sources that you want to match. I'll add an Accounts Receivable data source as a source system. The source system and subsystem options determine which side the transactions for this data source are included in during period end reconciliation. Select Allow Transactions to be Deleted if you want preparers to be able to delete transactions from reconciliations that use this match type. Select Allow Transactions to be Split if you want preparers to be able to split transactions for one-to-many, many-to-one, or many-to-many matches to match part of a transaction, leaving aside only the split remaining amount unmatched. This helps keep the number of unmatched transactions as low as possible at the end of each day, and allows a reviewer to look at a reconciliation with fewer unmatched transactions. Next, I'll add an Accounts Payable data source as a subsystem. Transactions for the Accounts Payable data source will be matched against transactions for the Accounts Receivable data source. For each data source, you add attributes corresponding to the data fields you want to import from your source system. I'll add an attribute for the invoice date. You assign a data type to each attribute. Select key if the values in the field must be unique, and required if the field cannot be left blank. I'll make this attribute the accounting date. The accounting date is critical to the period end balancing process because it determines the accounting period the transaction belongs to, and consequently, whether the transaction is included in a particular period end reconciliation. Each data source must include one accounting date attribute, and it must be required. If you want preparers to be able to edit transactions in a new or supported state on the Unmatched Transactions dialog, select Allow Edit. You can allow editing to multiple attributes in a data source, but it must be done one attribute at a time. Each data source must include one balancing attribute also. I'll add an attribute for the invoice amount and make it the balancing attribute. Similar to the accounting date, the balancing attribute is critical to the period end balancing process because it's used for period end balance calculations. The data type must be either number or integer, and it must be required. If you need to transform the imported data, you can select Calculation to create a calculated attribute. For example, you could reverse the sign for a numeric value or perform rounding. You can define filters for a data source. You use filters to select a subset of transactions in the data source when performing tasks such as exporting journals. I'll create a filter for transaction ID 698. I'm done working on this match type for now, so I'll close it. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.